PPW High Voltage, alongside the Juice. E. Julius Kuiper, I almost forgot your name for a minute. I'm your host, Paul Ball. Guys, tonight, in our main event, you talk about a pedigree a mile long, EJ. Jeff Jarrett, the King of the Mountain, the founder of TNA Wrestling and now Global Force Wrestling, is coming to PPW tonight. And who is he taking on?
None other than Mr. Excellence, Brandon Scott, Jeff Jarrett. Few people in the entire history of wrestling have a pedigree as strong as Jeff Jarrett. But Mr. Excellence, Brandon Scott, one of the best all-around athletes on the independent wrestling circuit today. You might not like his attitude, but he is one of the best. You heard it here.
He's one of the cockiest, he's condescending, and he's definitely arrogant. But he is Mr. Excellence, Brandon Scott. We'll see what the King of the Mountain has in store for Brandon Scott tonight on High Voltage, your main event.
PPW. Oh boy. Why am I going to win the PPW Royal Rumble? There's a lot of reasons why I'm going to do it. But the main one is,
I always tell you, welcome to the era of hearts.
Mark Hart.
The opening contest is set for one fall and is for the WYLN Television Championship. Introducing first, the challenger from parts unknown, weighing 250 pounds, he is the bearded menace, Havoc! Approaching the ring from Manoa, Hawaii, weighing 220 pounds, he is the reigning, defending WYLN Television Champion, the Flying Hawaiian, Kekoa!
champion, EJ, the Flying Hawaiian Kekoa. We saw him last month finally take the gold from the Bearded Menace Havoc. It was an emotional night here in January for PPW. I'll tell you what, he got engaged that night. It was just a touching scene. What a better way to top off a night with a gold.
Look at this already. Havoc goes for the cheap shot right out of the corner. Kekoa scouts it. Kekoa taking it to Havoc. He knows this his game all too well. Irish whip, hard into the corner. Kekoa is not pulling any punches tonight. The WYLN TV champion means business, folks. I have never seen him this aggressive. I've never seen him this thirsty for blood in all my years of calling matches. He has Havoc against the ropes. There's some hard. Havoc holds on. Tosses Kekoa, lands on the apron, back elbow. Havoc full steam ahead. Kekoa scouts it.
Oh, up and Kekoa over.
Right to the outside.
I'll tell you what, EJ, Kekoa is fastly becoming here a fan favorite here at PPW. Havoc's down on the ground here, and you know as well as I do, there's nothing harder than the gym floor here at Holy Family Academy.
Look at this, unbelievable! He took Havoc right out, putting his body on the line. High risk, high reward, Paul Bone.
Tell you what, if Kekoa would have missed that one, it could have been lights out. But like you said, a high risk, high reward maneuver, paying off.
Unreal.
No here, no here.
Watch your laptop.
Bubba, I was just saying.
Oh, man.
I have never seen Kekoa this aggressive before.
You can hear those chops back in Hawaii, I think.
Absolutely. He fought long and hard to gain that TV television championship, and he's not going to give it up without a fight, I'll tell you that much.
He's giving him the tour to ring here, EJ.
Forearm smash. He's pointing it out like Babe Ruth off the fences.
I'll tell you what, those front row seats are a high commodity here in PPW. That guy's here every month. He sticks his foot up, and it's always being used as a weapon. Referee David Stone being very liberal here with a 10 count.
Well, as long as it's not a loaded boot, it's technically not illegal. Look at this. Kekoa is just beating Havoc all the way around the ring.
There goes Havoc. I don't know, something just fell out of Havoc's mouth. I'm not even sure what it is.
Havoc reverses. Oh my God.
Right to those. And I'll tell you what, there's no giving no steps, EJ.
Paul Bo, I'll tell you what, I carry those up and down before and after every show. It takes three men to carry those steps.
They are heavy.
They barely move. They barely move. The full-grown man just went careening into those steps, and they barely moved an inch, folks.
And I'll tell you what, EJ, this match has now become a no-holds-barred, anything-goes match here. David Stone now is out to join him on the outside here. And I mean, seriously, how much more can he take here?
Oh, and he picks him up and drops him like a broken elevator.
Like a broken elevator. Havoc's now stalking his prey here, and he's eyeing up that television title. Crowd's giving it to him here, EJ. They don't like that at all.
What does Havoc have in mind here? Double axe handle from the apron. Look at this, Bobo. I'm sure both these men had a strategy coming into this match. All that went out the window.
Yeah, I'll tell you what, there's just bad blood in this match. No one likes each other in this match. This feud's been going on full circle now a year, EJ. They've been chasing each other. Havoc had the belt. Kekoa's chasing him. And now Kekoa is the champion. And this is all over Sammy Pandora, the love of Kekoa's life.
Bobo, I'll tell you what. I don't know what Kekoa is thinking, getting into a fist fight with Havoc, but that's his specialty. This guy learned how to fight out on the streets. Look at that, goes down low with the drop kick. He's not just a brawler too, as we've said many times before. what makes Havoc so dangerous is he is an all-around opponent. He can hit you from any angle, from the ground, from his feet, from his knees. He can always bring it to you no matter where he is in the squared circle.
Not to cut you off, EJ, here. Havoc now twisting the neck of Kekoa here. That's definitely an uncomfortable position here, and I'll tell you what, that'll definitely snap something in your neck. You'll be going to see Dr. Palermo tomorrow, EJ.
Absolutely. Crowd slip some discs in the neck.
Crowd trying to will Kekoa back to his feet here. Havoc's trying to siphon the crowd here.
Kekoa struggling to the vertical base. Fighting out with those back elbows. Reaching deep. Could he break free? The TV champ is out. Off the ropes. Oh, and right into a knee.
Caught him full 360, EJ. Put Kekoa down on the mat that took the wind right out of him. And Havoc, the veteran that he is, I say it all the time, he pounces right out of him. Now that's 220 pounds, and Kekoa just got thrown around the ring.
Two and a half. And the pump handle slam, gut wrench slam, excuse me. And look at that. Havoc just executed a power maneuver on the small of the back, and now he's going right to work, putting the pressure on, applying the pressure to the area that he just damaged.
I'll tell you what, EJ, what did a little suck the wind right out of you? I mean, Kekoa, you can see here, it's like almost like a bolt constrictor. The more he struggles to get out, the tighter Havoc's grip has become. Havoc has it locked in pretty deep, EJ. I don't know if he's going to get out of this.
Again with those vicious back elbows. The champ trying to fight out. Kekoa off the ropes, ducks the clothesline. Beautiful flying forearm. Takes Havoc off the vertical base. Havoc scouts it. No.
Right behind the head.
Kekoa right back at it. Flapjack.
This could be the opening that Kekoa is looking for, EJ, but how much can he take? How much damage was sustained on his body? Havoc with those clubbing leg blows. Havoc is down on the mat, flat on his back. Kekoa is going up top, EJ.
We know what happens from here, Paul Bow. Can he retain? Can the Flying Hawaiian legitimize his reign right here and now? Havoc back to the vertical base. Quickly to the corner and to the middle rope. Meets Kekoa up above the ring. Headbutt. Down goes Havoc. Kekoa feeding off the energy for the PPW Nation. Beautiful elbow drop from the stratosphere. Oh. Paul Bow, honestly, I thought that was all she wrote. Most people cannot kick out of a top rope elbow drop by the Flying Hawaiian. Listen to this crowd, firmly behind the WYLN TV champion. Havoc crawled to the corner, struggling to get to the vertical base. Turns around, scouts the kick. Oh, beautifully executed German suplex in the spear.
Oh, what a spear. This is it, EJ.
We have a new champion. Oh, no. Kekoa kicks out.
Tell you what, how did he kick out of that one, EJ? I'll tell you what, Havoc fought him clean with that spear. I can't believe he kicked out of it.
I don't think I've ever seen anyone kick out of that spear, Paulo.
And now frustration is starting to set in on Havoc here. He just keeps covering him left and right.
What a matchup we're seeing here, folks. Just a testament to how important this belt is in this company.
The WYLN Television Championship has quickly become a very hot commodity in PPW, EJ. From the British Wolf to Mark Hart to Kekoa to Havoc.
Absolutely. What does Havoc have in mind here? This bulldozes Kekoa into the corner. I don't know how smart it is to put Kekoa on the top rope, Paul Bow. As I've said before, that's like putting Br'er Rabbit in the briar patch.
I'll tell you what, EJ, if Havoc hits this one, it's lights out. He's going for a superplex. Kekoa blocked it. His legs are locked here around that top turnbuckle.
Absolutely. Veteran ring presence from Kekoa.
trying to fight out, club and blow across the back. Trying those headbutts again, Havoc.
Crowd chanting, let's go Havoc.
Beautiful maneuver from Kekoa.
He caught him clean, EJ. He caught him clean.
Absolutely, ran into that foot like a brick wall.
He got him.
What a matchup.
Here is your winner and the still WYLN Television Champion, the Flying Hawaiian, Kekoa.
Tell you what, EJ, what a fantastic matchup here. And finally, I think Kekoa has put an end to the rivalry with the Bearded Menace Havoc, getting successful wins in the past 2 months here, only on PPW High Voltage.
Absolutely. Havoc ran into that super kick like it was a cinder block. If he hasn't learned his lesson yet, I don't know what's going to sink in.
And listen to this crowd showing their appreciation for the Flying Hawaiian Kekoa.
This bout is set for one fall, approaching the ring, hailing from Robbinsdale, Minnesota, weighing 195 pounds, Mr. Excellence, Brandon Scott! From Music City, USA, weighing 232 pounds, Jarrett!
people gonna let me in the ring?
I don't know. You better get Davy Crockett to move you back. Event here on PPW High Voltage, EJ. Jeff Jarrett, the King of the Mountain, taking on Mr. Excellence, Brandon Scott. You can see what went on earlier. Jeff Jarrett's very upset. Brandon Scott flat out disrespected him, EJ. Flat out.
Paul Bowen, he disrespected a man who held over 74 championships throughout his career. I think that might be unparalleled in this business.
Yes, he did. Six-time WWE Intercontinental Champ, to be exact, EJ.
Get in the ring, Barney.
Six-time NWA Heavyweight Champion during his tenure at TNA, a company he helped found.
Yep. Doesn't get any better than Jeff Jarrett.
Triple-A Heavyweight Champion down in Mexico, I believe.
And a third-generation wrestler, too. You don't see too many of them. His father, the great Jerry Jarrett, grandfather Eddie Martin. Awesome. What a family, the Jarretts. A lot of chairs going around tonight. And Brandon Scott likes to play a game of cat and mouse. We've seen it the last 4 months here in PPW with Sean Carr, Jay Freddy, then Sean Carr and Jay Freddy. He likes to get in their head. He plays a little head games, but you're not playing with a guy like Jeff Jarrett here. I mean, this is...
Absolutely. He's seen every trick.
What's that? Be careful. Oh, he did him already. They wouldn't let me. Got the Bullet Club vest from Jeff Jarrett here.
Looking good there, huh? Try it on, Paul, though.
Now.
Brandon Scott's out of here. Now, I have to agree with Brandon Scott. If he wins tonight, there's very little who would argue that he doesn't deserve a shot at the PPW Heavyweight Championship.
David Stone just pushed Jeff Jarrett. Jeff Jarrett with another push. David Stone! Down goes Jeff Jarrett!
What are we seeing here, Paul Bowe? David Stone showing who's boss. He's breathing heavy.
I'll give David Stone credit. You've got to take the initiative here. You've got to take charge, or these guys will push you around.
Absolutely. Here we go, folks, main event.
Jeff Jarrett still staring at David Stone.
Get your dirt out of the ring there, Jeff.
Still arguing with David Stone. That's like arguing with a wall. Did he just bless himself?
I have no idea. I'm a little confused here. One thing I'm not confused about, though, this is going to be one heck of a matchup. They're saying kill the ref, Paul Bowe.
Definitely saying kill the ref.
Jeff Jarrett backs up Brandon Scott into the corner.
Jeff Jarrett with a big weight advantage on Brandon Scott here.
I
Look at this. Jeff Jarrett does not appreciate being touched by David Stone here.
Oh!
Brandon Scott saying he pulled his hair. Folks want to see a wrestling match here. I can't say I disagree with them.
David Stone needs to get nailed here.
Well, that's... that's the understatement of the century.
He just told David Stone to sit down and he'll call the match himself.
And look at this. He just pulled Jeff Jarrett by the hair. Look at the smile on Brandon Scott's face.
He's playing right into his plans. Are they saying kill the ref?
They absolutely are, Paul Bo.
Tommy Slade better get down here and take charge of this.
Jeff Jarrett growing more and more frustrated.
That's your turn. I just figured it out. You are the Oompa Loompa kid. And I should have known that we have the ugly, wicked witch of the West in the house.
Look at that. Jeff Jarrett mocking Brandon Scott. Making fun of a short man for his height. That's a low blow. Get it?
I get it.
Is this match against Jeff Jarrett and David Stone, or is it against Jeff Jarrett and Brandon Scott? I have no. Jeff Jarrett's looking at us like we know what's going on. He's like, where do you find these guys?
I'll hit them and let me get up there. I'll nail them.
Now, come on, Brandon Scott. Don't say he's going to disqualify him.
If he disqualifies him, Jeff Jarrett's going to clean his clock. Look at David Stone. He's a complete disaster.
I want to see a wrestling match, Bobo. That's what these people paid to see. That's what Jeff Jarrett came all this way to do.
What are they saying?
Tuck your shirt in.
David Stone is getting so much heat here.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
He was just checking it to see if that was a wig or not.
And the game of cat and mouse begins.
Tell you what, we said Brandon Scott was going to play games. He's never taken it to this length before.
Collar and elbow tie up once again. Brandon Scott, big hip toss to Double J, Jeff Jarrett. What a smug, arrogant young man he
look
is.
Look at the look of disgust on the face of Jeff Jarrett. You are mocking one of the greatest champions ever.
Absolutely.
This Brandon Scott kid, I'll tell you what, he has absolutely no respect for anyone, no respect for any authority, and he's going to get his someday.
You know what, Bobo, wrestlers don't come along like Jeff Jarrett anymore. He's learned the craft by traveling around the world, winning championships. He's learned the craft as a third generation wrestler. You just don't hear of things like that anymore.
Absolutely. I'm gonna put my headset on. I think we're gonna finally get down to some action.
They tie up again. Jockeying for position here. Brandon Scott again with the hip toss. Mocking Jeff Jarrett once again.
Paulbo, this is how rivalries are born.
Absolutely, when you show no respect for anyone.
David Stone arguing again with Jeff Jarrett. Brandon Scott eyeing up Jeff Jarrett in the corner here. Very slow-paced matchup.
Very slow pace. I think I saw Freddie Akers walking faster earlier this afternoon.
Tell you what, slow, fast. Jeff Jarrett has wrestled every type of matchup you could imagine. It doesn't matter to him. He'll wait until Brandon Scott's ready to start fighting. But look at this. Brandon Scott again with the advantage. I wish I could say I'm surprised, Paulbo, but I never, ever count Brandon Scott out. I might not agree with the way he acts, with his attitude, but he is one heck of a wrestler.
Absolutely, can't take that away from him.
And if anyone could take it to a man as esteemed as Jeff Jarrett, it is Brandon Scott. Oh my God, and that is how you execute a hip toss.
Threw him like a child, EJ.
Jeff Jarrett. Loaded up the big right hand.
Down goes Brandon Scott, and quickly out of the ring.
Brandon Scott, no spring chicken himself. And that is how it's done, folks. Look at the look on Brandon Scott's face. He knew if he got caught there, it would be all over. Look at that, taking the knee right to Jeff Jarrett. You know, some men, they try and learn from guys like Jeff Jarrett. Brandon Scott, he just wants to humiliate legends and superstars. And the more highly esteemed you are, the better he wants to beat you.
Tell you what, though, what a notch in the belt of Brandon Scott would this be, for Brandon Scott would this be if he could take out someone with such a pedigree as Jeff Jarrett.
Absolutely. Like I said before, if he could pull off a victory here, there's few who would argue that he doesn't deserve a shot at the heavyweight championship.
Oh, it's only a matter of time, EJ, before Brandon Scott is wearing some kind of gold here in PPW, whether it's a tag team belt, whether it's a no limits belt, but after what Offa done, I don't know who's going to take that off him. Television champion or even world heavyweight champion, EJ.
Absolutely.
Brandon Scott could wrestle in any weight division against any type of opponent. Look at this blading choke.
That's more than 5 seconds.
That is way more than 5 seconds.
I know David Stone can't count, but my God, that must have been 10 seconds in the corner.
Oh!
Man, Brandon laying it in there.
Right across the chin. Stiff right hands in the corner, and look at that, just like that, Jeff Jarrett biding his time, saw his opportunity. Oh, now come on!
Come on, David Stone!
What was that, what was he calling, a close fist? What is this, 1975? Unreal!
And you give a Brandon Scott an opening like that, and he takes advantage of it, as you saw right there, EJ.
He was calling the close fist, Paulbo. Scoop it a slam.
Tell you what, I haven't seen a close fist in style like that since Stone's hairdo, EJ. That's how long that's been.
And what do you call that? That was for the top rope. Middle rope, and... Brandon Scott grown very frustrated. The look of disgust on his face. Look at those right hands from Jeff Jarrett and a left. He comes from all the way behind him, Paulbo, with those blows. Those aren't quick jabs, those are all haymakers. Brandon Scott gets down, Jarrett off the rope. Beautiful dropkick for Brandon Scott.
Bottom square right in the face, EJ.
Tell you what, the pace is picked up in this matchup now. No more fooling around. No more cat and mouse. This one's full steam ahead.
Brandon Scott has Jeff Jarrett down on the ground right now, and he's taking full advantage of it, EJ.
Rear chin lock from Brandon Scott, deeply applied. Shoving the knee into the back. Right between the shoulder blades. Jarrett up to one knee, struggling, trying to feed off the energy of the PPW Nation as he struggles to get to the vertical base. Back elbow after back elbow. Jeff Jarrett fighting out off the ropes. No, right into a sleeper hold, Paulbo. Brandon Scott with the sleeper hold deeply applied.
Jeff Jarrett's trying to get to the ropes, EJ. Trying to get to the ropes. He's fading fast.
He's going down, Paulbo. We saw in a different matchup, we saw a victory last month with someone getting choked out. Will we see another match? Victory with the sleeper hold. You don't see it too much anymore, Paulbo.
And I'll tell you what, Jeff's in a bad position. He's on his back, and Brandon has it locked in deep. He has no lower body strength left to get him push himself out, and there's only so much you can take before they cut off that oxygen to the brain there, and it's lights out, EJ. And that's what happened exactly last month with Bull Hightower.
Absolutely. Cut off. You cut off the airway. There's a huge nerve right beneath the chin. Where Brandon Scott's elbow is firmly applied. And then there's pressure applied to the back of the head. One of the most devastating moves in professional wrestling. It's been around for so long for a reason.
Here it is, he's checking, this is the third time,
this
he's done.
This has to be it. Oh, no! Back from the dead, Paulbo. Everything he has left, Jeff Jarrett. Feeding off the PPW Nation, trying to get back to the vertical base and fight out of the sleeper hold. Brandon Scott doesn't know what to do now. Jeff Jarrett, Brandon Scott up. Big backdrop.
Both men laid out on the ring, EJ. Carnage everywhere here. First man to get to the vertical base will definitely have the advantage in this one. We're definitely well past TV time here. I hope they don't cut us off. but both men are laid out, EJ, on the canvas. Tell me what's going through the mind right now of either man as they're laid out there. Clear the cobwebs. Talk to me, EJ.
Well, Bo, the only thing on both these men's mind is to get that three count right now. Nothing else matters. That is what every part of their body is willing towards now. It's to get back to their feet, deliver that final move, and get the three count.
Tell you what, listen to this crowd. They are absolutely deafening here.
Bobo, Brandon Scott looking to prove himself here at PPW, get what's rightfully his. Jeff Jarrett here to defend his legacy as they begin to duke it out in the middle of the squared circle. Folks, you're not going to get this anywhere else. You're not going to get this on Monday nights. Only here at PPW, you're going to get matchups like this.
And they are just laying haymakers in, EJ, lefts and rights.
Look at this. This is what it's devolved to. Jeff Jarrett blocks the right hand again. Looking for the advantage. This might be what the veteran, the legend, was looking for. Brandon Scott off the ropes. Runs into a back elbow like a brick wall. Jeff Jarrett full steam ahead. It's very beautifully done.
Look at Brandon Scott. He don't even know where he is, EJ. Here's the cover.
Like
very
I said.
Very slow count. Very slow count by David Stone. Very slow count. Jeff Jarrett's had enough. Very slow count.
That is like poking a bear on the behalf of David Stone. Oh, now come on. That was blatant.
Dirtiest trick in the book. He poked him right in the eyes.
I told you never count out Brandon Scott, especially when he is near defeat. Like he just, whoa!
Jeff Jarrett moved just in the nick of time, EJ.
Absolutely. He saw him in his peripheral, waited until Brandon Scott was at the apex of his jump, and then simply sidestepped. That is a veteran ring
presence.
They're
calling for the stroke, EJ.
Here we go, Brandon Scott. No, fights out. Jeff Jarrett in the corner, vulnerable position, full steam ahead, no! Jeff Jarrett sidesteps. This one is a seesaw matchup. Double leg takedown.
His legs are on the ropes.
The ropes.
His
oh,
legs are on the ropes. Are you kidding
me? Upset.
Are you kidding me?
Bobo, can we just talk about that upset?
Here is your winner, Mr. Excellence, Brandon Scott.
I can't believe it.
I'll tell you what, that was absolutely a total disgrace. His legs were up on the ropes, and once again, a referee in PPW has screwed something up for the PPW Nation.
Bobo,
are you kidding me?
You gotta give it to Brandon Scott. He came and took what he wanted. He was sick of waiting.
Tommy Slade's the commissioner up there. He's looking up there. He saw it up there with his own two eyes. What went on here? It was an absolute disgrace.
I'll tell you what, you want to talk about notches and a belt? How about that one for Brandon Scott? I'm sure he's going to have something to say.
Hold on a second, hold on. Justice prevailed finally here in PPW.
David Stone setting precedent here.
Well, Haley Culp spotted it over there, as everybody did here in the arena here. I had to go over and call her attention. Referee David Stone has reset it. He hit him with the stroke, EJ!
That has to be it.
He got him!
Here's your winner, Jeff Jarrett.
Standing ovation here at PPW for the King of the Mountain himself, Mr. Jeff Jarrett. Listen to this capacity crowd as they're cheering for an icon, a legend, the 2015 TNA Hall of Famer himself, none other than the King of the Mountain, Jeff Jarrett.
What an honor it's been to call a match for someone I grew up watching. As a kid, I got to call one of his matches tonight, Double J Jeff Jarrett, class act, folks.
We're signing off. We'll see you next month, March 19th. Xbox coming to town. Free Julius Kuiper. I'm Paul Bowe saying good night from PPW.